Among the distinguished guests, Secretary of Labor and Mrs. George Shultz, Duke Ellington's son, Mercer, with members of his family. Musical stage star Cab Calloway with Mrs. Calloway. Clarinetist Benny Goodman and his wife. Singer Billy Eckstein and Mrs. Eckstein. Dr. and Mrs. Arthur Logan. Magazine publisher John Johnson and Mrs. Johnson. Other guests include leaders in the fields of art and religion. Trumpeter Dizzy Gillespie. The guest of honor, Duke Ellington, arrives with his sister, Ruth Ellington. Birthday greetings have come from every continent, but none are warmer than those of President and Mrs. Richard Nixon. Tonight, a special program of Ellington compositions is played by a hand-picked band representative of the profession in which he excels.
Received from Mr. Conover the information that if we will all rather gradually move to that room next door, and there are refreshments there and also music, this room will be cleared, the band will return, and they will have a jam session and dancing for all those who want. How about it?
Well, they call it Stormy Monday, but Tuesday just as bad. Well, the eagle flies on Friday,
Start from right now, and and I shall pick a name, and see if I can improvise on it. Something, you know, very gentle, and graceful, and something like, let's say, for instance, Pat. How's that?
We have a presentation to make, and I was looking at this name on here, and it says Edward Kennedy Ellington.
Well, think they like it.
For the first time during this administration, I have the honor of presenting the Presidential Medal of Freedom. And I think it is most appropriate that that medal be presented to Duke Ellington. When we think of freedom, we think of many things. But Duke Ellington is one who has carried the message of freedom to all the nations of the world through music, through understanding. Understanding that reaches over all national boundaries and over all boundaries of prejudice and over all boundaries of language. And because he has an unusual gift, a gift that he has shared with us, his own fellow citizens and with the citizens of the world, we believe that this citation fits him particularly well. I will read it to you. The President of the United States of America awards this Presidential Medal of Freedom to Edward Kennedy Ellington. Edward Kennedy Ellington, pianist, composer, and orchestra leader, has long enhanced American music with his unique style, his intelligence, his impeccable taste. For more than 40 years, he has helped to expand the frontiers of jazz while at the same time retaining in his music the individuality and freedom of expression that are the soul of jazz. In the royalty of American music, no man swings more or stands higher than the Duke.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Presidential Medal of Freedom. And the word freedom is one, coincidentally, that we are using at the moment in our sacred concert. And, of course, we speak of freedom of expression. We speak of freedom generally as being something very sweet and fat and things like that. But at the end, when we get down to the payoff, what we actually say is that we would like very much to mention the four major freedoms that my friend and writing and arranging composer Billy Strayhorn lived by and enjoyed. And that was freedom from hate unconditionally, freedom from self-pity, freedom from fear of possibly doing something that may help someone else more than it would him, and freedom from the kind of pride that could make a man feel that he is better than his brother.
Happy birthday to him, and please, in the key of G.